Amphan, one of the fiercest cyclones to have affected West Bengal, Odisha, and the neighboring Bangladesh in decades, has unleashed havoc on the ecologically sensitive Sundarbans region. Ghoramara Dweep and Kalinagar in Kak Dweep, Namkhana, Bakhali, Fraserganj, Sagar, and Prathor Pratima Islands in South 24 Parganas are the worst affected areas where rescue and relief operations are being carried out. The cyclone has destroyed the river embankment across the Sundarbans, which has led to salt water entering the land. As per a report, Sundarbans Affairs Minister Mantoram Pakhira said that nearly 17,800 hectares of agricultural lands may have been damaged because of it. 1,08,000 farmers could be affected.
It has created havoc in many of the parts of the Sundarban Biosphere Reserve. Mostly in the Ganga Sagar Island, there are many agriculture as well as the orchards which are severely affected, and the crops are completely damaged. There are also evidences about the faunal changes in Sundarban Biosphere Reserve, and particularly the arboreal species are most affected one. And among them, the birds whose nests are present in the trees, many areas, particularly in the Kak Dweep and other areas, the bird nests are completely broken and destroyed by the cyclone. In many places, even in the Kaining area and other places, the seawater has entered into agriculture fields. And that has also devastated the agriculture crops. The fishing activity also hampered in Namkhana and the Kak Dweep area. Overall, the scenario of Sundarban devastation is very, very difficult to observe.
Sundarban, which means beautiful forest, is the largest mangrove forest in the world. It is spread around 1,40,000 hectares and lies on the delta of Ganga, Brahmaputra and Meghna rivers on the Bay of Bengal. It became inscribed as a UNESCO World Heritage Site in the year 1987. What makes it unique? UNESCO describes it as a site intersected by a complex network of tidal waterways, mud flats and small islands of salt-tolerant mangrove forests, and presents an excellent example of ongoing ecological processes. The area is known for its wide range of fauna, including 260 bird species, the Bengal tiger, and other threatened species such as the estuarine crocodile and the Indian python. Sundarban is the only mangrove forest in the world which is home to the tiger. Sundarban Tiger Reserve has the highest tiger population in the world. Sundarban's ecosystem also acts as a natural fish nursery. Millions of people depend on it for their livelihood and sustenance through fishing, collection of honey and fuel. Why are mangroves important? Sundarban mangrove reduces the fury of cyclonic storms and prevents erosion due to tidal action.
The mangroves actually work as a break, because when the huge winds come in from the Bay of Bengal, from the sea, mangroves acts as a friction barrier, because at the lower level, at the house level, at the human level, the mangroves slow down the winds very, very strongly.
Why are mangroves under threat?
In the last three decades, we have lost around 10,000 hectares of mangroves in the Sundarbans areas, which is roughly 100 square kilometers. It's a massive area. But this pressure is increasing. The more we face the destruction, but with the destruction of the mangroves, both by human pressure, the cutting of the forest, which is little less in India but more in Bangladesh, and also by disturbing the balance of the delicate saline and freshwater balance and the tidal and the upstream river silt, we are actually killing the mangroves from both ways.
Sundarban mangrove forest played a huge role in reducing the impact of cyclones Alia and Bulbul. Experts say they not only reduce the wind speed drastically, but also help to break the waves during a storm.
So what is happening is the winds are coming in, the cyclone and the tropical storms winds are coming in unimpeded, very strongly, and they are destroying large amount of houses, property, trees, everything. So if the Sundarbans have to be preserved, not only for the nature, for environment, but the people of the Sundarbans and upstream up to Kolkata and beyond, because Kolkata and Dhaka, these two mega cities, are also very, now we have seen that with Amphan, are very, very vulnerable if we allow the cyclones to come in.